Let us now try to understand how can we connect the photovoltaic cells in two different ways so that we can increase the potential difference. Last year you have studied about resistors connected in series and parallel. When resistors were connected in series, the total potential difference was given by the sum of the potential differences across the resistors. Similarly, we also studied that when resistors are connected in series combination, the current through each resistor remains the same as the total current flowing through the circuit. Here we have two photovoltaic cells, cell 1 and cell 2. They are connected in series combination. V1 is the potential difference across cell 1 and V2 is the potential difference across cell 2. So the total potential difference will be equal to sum of the potential difference across cell 1 plus potential difference across cell 2. That is, V total potential difference is equal to V1 plus V2. We have even studied that when resistors are in series combination, the current through each resistor is same as the total current in the circuit. So here if we have the total current to be I that is flowing, that will be equal to the current flowing through cell 1 that is I1, and the same current will be flowing through cell 2 that is I2. So it means that when solar cells or photovoltaic cells are connected in series, currents from the individual cells are not added. Here we have the two cells connected in parallel combination. When we studied resistors in parallel last year, we studied that the potential difference across each resistor is the same as the total potential difference in the circuit. And we saw that the current that will be flowing through the entire circuit will be given by the sum of the currents flowing through individual resistors. Here we have two cells again, cell 1 and cell 2, but now they are connected in parallel combination. I1 is the current flowing through cell 1, I2 is the current flowing through cell 2. So the potential difference across both will be equal to the potential difference across cell 1, and the same potential difference will also be there across cell 2. So V, that is total potential difference in the circuit, is equal to the potential difference across cell 1, that is V1, which is equal to potential difference across cell 2, that is V2. But as far as the current is concerned, the total current that will be flowing will be equal to sum of the current that is flowing through cell 1, that is I1, plus the current that is flowing through cell 2, that is I2. So from here we come to know that if two solar cells are connected in parallel combination, then the potential difference from two cells are not added. So when they are in series combination, the current is not added, and when they are in parallel combination, we find that the potential differences are not added. Thus, if we want to increase the total potential difference and the current in the photovoltaic cells, we need to connect many such solar cells or photovoltaic cells in series and parallel combination. So by connecting many solar cells in series and parallel combination, we get a solar panel. And such a solar panel will help us to generate current and potential difference that are required by us. Now here you have one example where we have got 36 solar cells and the size of each solar cell is 100 centimeter square and they are connected in series combination. So we know that when cells are connected in series combination, the current across each of them will remain same, but the potential difference will get added up. Just as we had studied here, that the total potential difference across the circuit will be equal to the potential difference across each cell. So here we have 36 solar cells. In one line we have got 9. Here in a row we have 9 solar cells, and vertically in the column you have got 4. So total number becomes 9 4s are 36. So there are 36 solar cells. Size of each cell is 100 centimeters square, and they are all connected in series combination. We have already studied that from one solar cell we are getting 0.5 volts potential difference. So if there are 36 such cells, then they will give rise to a potential difference of 18 volts. The current will remain the same, that is 3 amperes, because they are connected in series combination. A good solar cell can have an efficiency of around 15%, and it means that if a solar panel receives power of 100 watt from solar radiation, the electrical power output from the panel will be 15 watts. So this is a solar panel that is made out of 36 solar cells connected in series combination, and the total potential difference is 18 volts and current is 3 amperes. Many solar panels are connected in series and in parallel to generate required current and potential difference. Solar cell is the basic unit in solar electric plant. Many solar cells come together to form a solar panel. Many solar panels connected in series form a solar string, and many solar strings connected in parallel form solar array. So here we have been shown, this is a single solar cell. Many such cells are connected here so as to give you a solar panel, and many such solar panels connected in series will give rise to a solar string. Here we can see strings of solar panels which are connected in parallel, and this will be called as a solar array. As we can obtain as much electrical power as needed, they are used in applications which are needed for marginal power, that is for calculators that run on solar energy to power station of megawatt capacity. So we know that by connecting many such solar panels in series and parallel combination, we can get the required current and potential difference, and hence it has got very varied applications. We can have instruments that require very small current and potential difference, like calculators or toys, and we can even have production on a very, very large scale, and we can produce even megawatts of electrical energy with the help of solar cells.